Welcome, Pranjal, to the show.
Thank you, Sachin. Thank you for having me.
Great. So to start with, it's been a COVID time and, you know, everything has come online. So what do you think are the new innovative ways that marketers can really think of, apart from traditional print stuff which goes on? So what could be the new innovative ways?
Starting from the last year, I would say a lot many people have become conscious about e-commerce. So initially, when people used to go in groups or in terms of families to the retail stores to buy their daily needs, now, of course, they cannot go. And again, after a year, the corona cases are on an increase. People have vastly shifted towards e-commerce. So e-commerce is something that I would say that has been on a continuous rise. Also, I would say that established FMCGs and retailers are also seeing a vast shift of people shifting to Amazon, to Flipkart, to other grocery retail platforms such as Big Basket and Grofers. All the retailers would say that although FMCGs, the established ones, have been there, they have seen a kind of decline in the sales that is happening. So it's kind of a bit of demotivating factor for any new product of any established FMCG to enter into the retail segment, or for any new product or any new brand to enter right now, since people are kind of leaving the retail stores and moving towards e-commerce. So I would say even in Zydus, when I'm working right now, it's a product which is completely digital release. It's not found in the retail stores. And with the increase in different occasions, let's say we had Holi, we had Valentine's Day. So people are getting more and more kind of occasions and reasons to go online and check what kind of promotions our brand doing in terms of digital marketing. So definitely e-commerce is the way to go. And I would say that people are becoming more tech savvy. So definitely performance marketing, e-commerce is the way that people would be purchasing their stuff now. You're not audible.
So would you recommend the print media, or what would be your thought on it?
So it depends on two things. First, how big your brand is, exactly what your brand objective is. So if I would say, let's say we have a new brand, SebaMed, in the market, right? And they have chosen both ways, to go into digital as well and to go into print media as well. So earlier in the last year, I would say that print media did get a bit of demotivation because there was a humongous lockdown and people couldn't go outside. People were not allowed to drive their cars, or even people who were single-handedly driving their cars, they were questioned a lot. The same restrictions are surfacing again. So print media will never lose completely its aura, I would say, but definitely it has a bit declined because India consists of more of youth as compared to the older generation. And the youth participates more on social media platforms and on digital platforms as compared to the print media. So, and of course, not this year, I would say, but definitely earlier, we had a lot many people canceling their subscriptions of the newspapers that they used to get. After a lot many months, they started that again. So definitely print media will be there, but the kind of aura, or you can say the relevance of print media, has been continuously decreasing in the lives of consumers as they shift more and more digital. And of course, we have WhatsApp. So a lot many people receive any sort of news segment or any sort of new entertainment segment through WhatsApp. So I would say digital is kind of the way to go for. So print media is a bit dicey. Depends on what kind of brand objective we have and where do we stand in our brand marketing.
Yes, to an extent, I think what you are saying, yes, it do matters. What are the brand preferences around it? So rightly, yes, true. So I was going through your profile and I saw a lot of stats around it. So, if you can share, how to work on the consumer insight, because as you are also suggesting, it's about e-commerce and a lot of money is been spent on the digital aspect. So how to work on the consumer insight and the research? One amazing terminology that I saw is there the persona mapping. So share something more about it.
So again, consumer insights are of two ways. It depends on if you're a new brand or a new product. So then you just get to know that what kind of gap that you're bridging in the market. In those terminologies, you do a survey as well. But as far as I have seen from my previous experiences, survey do play a role in consumer insights, but not as much as directly talking to the consumer does. The second stands for that even if you have an established product in the market, but somehow it's not performing or is it even performing, then you would like to see that where it stands in the market in terms of competitive analysis. And then you do a consumer research again to get to know what your perception of the brand is. So I have been part of both. I have been a part of the first one where you are making a product from the scratch. One of the basic rules of any consumer insight is never to discuss the product that you have in mind, and always make your consumer very at ease, because you do not want to sound as an interrogation. You just want to know about their lives. What happens is that any product or any service that you use will always have a specific time in the duration. So let's say if I wake up at 8 o'clock in the morning and sleep at 11 o'clock in the night. So if I'm using some sort of product, so I'm using some sort of service, that will have a set of time, maybe 2 o'clock in the afternoon or 4 o'clock in the evening. So how do I basically understand what importance does that product play in my life? Or if I am using, let's say, personal care products, if I'm using food products, what kind of food products am I consuming? Then what kind of food products do I have a preference for? So in that case, it's very essential for you to make your end consumer at ease and try to understand their life. Just try to understand and talk as a friend to them. That gives you way more insight as compared to completely making your, let's say, entire consumer insight experience as an interrogation. The second thing that also happens is that, again, when you are an established product in the market, but you just want to know the perception that people have about you, the similar thing happened is that you want to make your consumer at ease. And you just want to understand that what perception do they have right now in the market, and what kind of perception do you want people to think about? And then you see the gap. So one thing that, let's say, happened in sugar-free as well, that a lot many people who consume sugar-free has a perception that it's only meant for the diabetic people. But what perception do we want to make clear in sugar-free is that it's just not meant for diabetic people. Anyone can consume sugar-free because it contains natural ingredients, let's say sugar-free natura, so, or sugar-free gold. And also we have a new product out. So we just want to say that it's just not meant for the diabetic people. Anyone can consume it, because if you want to cut down on the sugar levels that you consume every day, and if you want to, you know, have a guilt-free consumption. Same with sugar-free delight chocolates as well that we have in the market, right? So, and also whenever you are doing consumer insights, when you come to buyer persona, one of the rules that you should always follow is not only getting to know your target consumer, but getting to know your super consumer, I would say. And super consumer is someone who you really deep dive. It's that niche part of your target segment where you just want to know that who are they? What do they consume? Why do they do that? And how do they do that? Once you deep dive, you genuinely get to know the life of that person, and then you're able to map them out in a very stated format. And then you get to know that, okay, this is the person you would like to target, and this is the person you would like to promote your product. So this is how you go about consumer insights, and then, you know, out of that, mapping everything in a single format.
Right, right. So, I mean, just taking cues here. So, can you elaborate a little bit about the super consumer you mentioned? So, what will be the advantage if I am into a mass category and you are taking it to the niche level taking the priorities to the super consumer? So, how it helps basically?
So, okay, if I am saying we're super consumer, normally what happens is for any business, from the past experiences, we have seen that 80% of the sales, 80% of the revenue comes from the 20% of the consumers. Either they are the ones who are very loyal, or either they are the ones who really find the best value for themselves in your product. We would like to target them in order to understand where our maximum revenue is coming, because ultimately for any business which is existing in the market, having revenue is the ultimate goal. So for that, what we do is that once we come into super consumer, we just start asking them different kind of questions, that what do they like in the brand? Like if we have, let's say, Sugar Free as a brand, or we have any sort of a brand. So what do they like about the brand? What do they dislike about it? What do they prefer? So this is something, their likes and dislikes. Also, we get to know about their purchasing decisions. That is, when do they go for their grocery shopping? Where do they consume their grocery shopping from? Is it online? Is it offline? And also genuinely getting to know who are they. So are they into some sort of, as we decide or as we divide, psychographical, like what do they think about it, or demographical, where do they live? What is their age? How much do they earn, and what have been they working on? Also, you get to know what are their goals and their pain points. Ultimately, what really happens is that trying to understand what is the gap that a consumer wants to fill in their lives. That gives you an idea that how can your product prove as a solution provider to that person in achieving their goals and pain points. So that is what you do with a super consumer, getting to know what are their aspirations and what are their goals, what do they like to see themselves, or how do they like to see themselves, let's say after 5 years, after 10 years, and slowly and gradually how our product would, get into their daily lives and how it would prove to be something which is really relevant and important for them. So that is what we mean by super consumer. And that gives you a good amount of segmentation on what kind of people can you target? How can you target them? Because ultimately, if you target those people the correct way, then your 80% of the revenue is done. And of course, 20% of the revenue can come when you target the rest of the consumers. They might be loyal, they might be not loyal, but once you have got a good command on the 20% who bring the 80% of the revenue, more than half of our work is done.
Right. Nicely explained. Perfect.